If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. It sorry says 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of the alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes!
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at insori@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we
can't guarantee a positive review.
Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is a community option. $1 at the gate gets you in a Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. What? Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah, yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go on the village, facebook.com/VinandSori. There's 160 plus thousand people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community connection, friendship, that type of thing.
But, and it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sori and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 tier and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
Buy our merch indeed. A child shall lead them
to buy our merch.
Speaking of which, if you're up on Patreon, go ahead, check it out. Your brother Vin just dropped a freestyle. Some mental ruminations about our current seats in Laban.
Okay, Slaughter to Prevail Bonebreaker is up next on our DJ Nick stream. DJ Nick on the ticker
Slaughter.
And over here.
Gosh.
So, you want a drink?
No, I don't need a drink. I don't know why people bring up drinks when people are
because when I'm doing that, it's
suffering.
Because my throat is dry. So we assume you're parched.
My parched.
Slaughter to Prevail Bonebreaker. The entire coast. Jalom record, and this song in particular drew heavy influence from Rammstein and especially Slipknot, specifically the Iowa album and all the records before.
Yeah, I definitely hear like early Slipknot
with
this band.
Everybody says that.
Yeah,
oh,
like,
well, I don't know about that, but everybody, that's everybody's favorite Slipknot is
Iowa,
Iowa and before.
Well, that version of Slipknot was the heaviest, angriest I've ever heard.
Oh, really?
In metal. It was just nothing close to
it. He says there's a live performance of this as well that I highly recommend you guys check out on your own time. Okay. You didn't want us to do the live version now.
Okay. Right? All right, guys. Here we go. Slaughter to Prevail. Big shout out to Danny Logan. Slaughter to Prevail.
B.A. Juice.
The name of this song is called Bone Breaker.
Yeah.
I'm actually really, really excited for this song because I'm here
for
the heavy.
No, Adam, you still have 3 songs left.
We're here for the heavy. Let's go. Whoa.
Oh,
totally saw the Rammstein and Slipknot influence in there, for sure.
For sure,
especially
for
at
sure,
the beginning
sure,
when
sure,
they were doing
sure,
the counting,
sure,
and I definitely
sure,
recognize
sure,
that to be Russian.
Heavy, bro. Heavy.
Yeah.
Heavy. I miss this kind of metal, bro. I really, really do. This is the metal I came up on, you know, like.
So when did this come out?
Once I discovered Korn.
Oh, 2021.
Korn, yeah. This is
oh,
new.
Oh, okay,
this is
cool.
New. Yeah, I mean, Keen, I'm not mad at you. Just can we chill out? I'm gonna be shooting some Middle America soon, bro. So you can let it fly there. But and you know, River has a pretty nuanced view on that situation. I don't think it's as simplistic as you're saying. Okay. This song was heavy as hell. This is a shit that I loved in high school when I was angry. I actually almost feel bad for kids like
that don't have this experience.
Slipknot was so important to me, like going through that place. Like it just gave you it gave you what you needed. Let me say it that way. But I really love this song. What about, do you like heavy?
Oh, I love heavy.
This is like, it's like hate metal. Like when you really, really hate somebody and shit, like, and you're like in no mercy mode, like you're not getting any mercy, bro. This is the shit. Go ahead. I'm sorry. What are you saying?
Yeah, I like this type of stuff. And I like when it's really, really heavy like that. I have to be, though, in the right mood, I guess you could say. Like this, I feel like I could listen to this song anytime and enjoy it. But there are times when we're in the car and I'm not feeling it and you put on some heavy stuff and I'm not feeling it at all. So I'm not sure why that is. I don't know if it's... I don't know.
Well, it is kind of exhausting to be that hateful. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, sometimes I'm like, babe, can you just put some R&B, something like...
Yeah, like
some
it's...
lovey
it's,
shit on?
It's pretty... It's pretty hard. It's pretty hard to carry that
kill
type of...
Kill your parents. Kill your... Darkness.
Not all of it.
Evil.
I was listening to a bunch
die,
of...
Die, motherfucker, die.
The last ride we were on, I was listening to Deftones. There's no die, motherfucker, die.
Yeah,
it's Deftones
just,
and Chevelle.
Yeah. I know. I'm exaggerating
Boy,
a little
you,
bit.
You love the drama, huh?
I'm exaggerating
she
a little
loves
bit
the drama.
For the fun of the story.
Your sister was an actress in her past life. She's
anyway.
She's still an actress.
So... It was fun hearing them do the intro.
Yeah, okay, that countdown.
Is this political?
What if a slave? What if I'm a slave and it takes forever? How could I know what the real life is? Okay, remember, some of the lyrics were a little bit awkward just because it wasn't perfect English, so the syntax was off a little bit. But you still get the idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Don't be dumb. Okay. Vin hates crap metal. as River says, anger is exhausting, but God, I love it sometimes. Not good for a marathon, though, when I'm working. Funnily, I find folk music more good for long periods of work.
Well, when the weather is nice and the windows are down and I just feel like that perfect air coming in and flying around me, I just want like fun stuff. I don't want the darkness stuff. There are times where I'm in the mood for that. It's just... When I'm on my way to the beach or something, like, that's not let's go to the beach music. It's not at all. That's like, let's go to a mosh pit or let's go fuck shit up. Let's go TP somebody's house or, you know.
You
what
and
I'm
the TPing. I'm well, really no, angry.
That was,
I will throw toilet paper no, at your roof. That'll show you, bitch.
This is what I was actually going to say.
Wait, what?
That's what I was gonna say, but I couldn't put that in there, so I had
yes,
to just.
Yes, I'm
I put
I'm
the
glad.
Stand in there. I put the stand in there as a TPing thing, but
yeah.
Figures you'd go attack that.
Yeah, well, I'm glad that you said that and not what you were going to say. I'm glad you said that and what you were going to say.
Okay, so what if I slave and it takes forever? How do I know what the real life is? So many ways. What about us? The geniuses of bombs, the robbers of pride, resenting. To public to conquer. This is soulless. Resenting to public to conquer. Self-affirmation. F off. With one hand they give you food. With one hand they give you food. With the other hand they will kill you, fool. It will kill you.
I like the way they did that.
Oh, I did too. I love that.
That's
part.
Some like hip hop accentuation. Yeah. He rhymed food with fool. Yeah, man. This was 2021. This came out. Okay, so he's Russian. This is a Russian band. So.
Well, that's really interesting.
I think he actually said something against Russia. I think he actually spoke out against Russia.
Really?
Well, I mean, you know what happens if you don't. If you're a tennis player and you don't come out and stomp on the Russian flag, they'll kick you out of the tournament. Ridiculous stuff. But go ahead. But like,
which part? The most obedient slave? I'm the eighth heart of Rockefeller. I'm the heart of...
They've got a song called Russian Hate. I would be very interested to hear that song.
Me too.
Yeah, so I don't know like what they said about the... I don't know if they... Okay, so Alex Terrible is a singer, and I guess he spoke out against the invasion.
Hey, you want to know something crazy?
Go ahead.
Speaking of government... whatever. So my friend, you know which one I'm talking about.
Yes.
Her kid is in like juvie, right?
Okay. Yep.
Every time they give him, because he's not 18, anytime that they give him anything, even a fucking Tylenol, they have to call her and get that cleared first because he's a kid. But they gave him the COVID shot without telling her. Yeah. And he was sick for a whole week. And he didn't want to tell her because he didn't want the drama. But then eventually they had to tell her. And she was really, really upset about that. Isn't that... Yeah. You know why? Apparently their establishment got paid for every shot they gave to each kid. So they didn't want to ask the parents. They just wanted to get the money. So
of
they
course.
Gave those kids all the shots.
It's unbelievable.
But if he needs a Tylenol because his head hurts, we got to call mommy.
Unbelievable.
That's just
shout
out to the governments everywhere.
Okay, so Alex Terrible has spoke out against the Russian invasion. That honestly, that doesn't tell me where he is politically or what he feels about Russia. So I'm not sure. And the reason I'm saying that is because especially if you are of Russian descent, if you don't speak out against Russia, then there are severe penalties that hit you. Whether you're an oligarch with your yacht or you're just a regular person on Twitch that makes their living on Twitch and PayPal and all this other shit got shut down. I told you about this person? She had a
Twitch
stream and they completely destroyed her. So I don't know. Yep. So now when you do things like that, it's always going to be under duress.
Yeah.
So I don't know how he feels about the situation. It could directly be... Now, this was in 2021 before the actual invasion happened. But remember, this has been since 2014. There have been...
This has been
amazing. And obviously even before that. So it's just hard to tell what's behind this other than you can talk about... the media and the elites in power putting us in a situation where we don't even know up from down, left from right. Like if you look at the opening lines, so many ways, what about us? How can I know what real life is? Bombs, the robbers of pride, resenting to public to conquer. So which is, to me, that's one of the biggest things that really hits me is how much elites truly resent people. They resent the people that vote for them.
Why? Well, I don't understand. Like, okay, just coming from like a human nature standpoint, why is that?
Well, I think it's kind of like the Matrix. You remember that conversation between Agent Smith and Morpheus when he's like, "I smell your stench" and all the rest of it. Like, when you're an elite and you're up there in the richest 0.5% of the world. You live a certain way. You have standards of living that are a certain way. And you just resent people. It'd be like, this is kind of a benevolent example. But when you go to, if you go to India in an untouchable ghetto where kids are literally swimming in the sewer, like for fun, there's a certain smell and things like that about them. It's like when we were downtown, there was a certain smell that was there just because people didn't have access to the resources that we had. Now, thankfully, God had moved in our hearts so that we loved those people. We didn't resent them. But left to our human nature, of course we'd have, resented them, for sure. The other thing, too, is that psychologically speaking, you cannot consistently mistreat people unless you resent them. So what these people are doing, like, for example, our government is, now they've come out and said it. You know, before when we were saying this, people were calling you a conspiracy theorist, all that nonsense. They just came out last week and said we're in a proxy war with Russia. So we're using these Ukrainians as meat shields so that we can continue a proxy war with Russia and weaken them so that we can be superior in the world stage and gas and all the rest of it. But in order to do that to people, you know people are going to die. You know people are going to suffer. But our government is pushing this. You're trying to win an election. You're trying to win the midterms. You've got people that can't afford, you can't get formula, whatever. And here's another $40 billion to Ukraine. Why? Because Biden's goal is obviously not re-election. Obviously. If the goal was re-election, there are things that you can do. And I told everybody, this whole shit that we're doing with Ukraine, this shit's going to get really unpopular when people are paying at the pump and they're paying, you're spending $8 on a package of chicken or eggs. All the fucking...
You just lowballed both of them.
All the blue and yellow flags in the world ain't going to change shit when that bill comes in. People are going to flip on... And it's already happening. But why... Why are we sending another $40 billion to them? And most of it's Raytheon and all. Because we have a plan. This is obvious. It's a plan. We're going to bleed these people out. We're going to bleed out the Russians. And we're going to use the Ukrainians as cannon fodder so that we can do that. My point is... That is a really horrible thing to do. And you have to hate people to get to the point where you stay the course and sustain it. So psychologically, they have to do that in order to maintain their power because you cannot treat people that way. You cannot look at people as chess pieces to just be moved across on a board unless you hate them. You can't do it on any long range type of way. That's my take on it. With one hand they give you food, the other hand they'll kill you.
That's the line that gets me. That's the one that, like, that line, the way he did it, music, like, the way that he did it in the song, it, like, was like, whoa. And also just, like, the concept, like, one hand food, one hand poison. It's just like,
yeah.
But at the same time, like, when I'm seeing this whole Pfizer thing, well, not just them, but any of the COVID shots and what was in it and how many pages and what they knew before they gave it to all of us and stuff. And, like, you know, on the one hand, Biden is throwing out all these checks to all of us that, you know, we haven't gotten one in a while, but, like, the ones that were coming out at the beginning, we kept getting these checks.
Yes, yes.
Everybody was getting these stimulus checks. So it's like, okay, here, all the food. And then in the other sense, they gave us something that they knew wasn't good yet. Like, they knew it wasn't
complete. Yeah, there's a lot of information about the blood clots, about heart issues with men. They held all, and, you know, look, that's the point of what he's saying, where he says, the most obedient slave is the one that doesn't understand that he's a slave. And you got people really believing, you got people really, dear listener, I'm about to say something really controversial.
Do it.
I say this all the time. You know, you got that picture, everybody's doing this thing, and you got the one guy doing this, and everybody wants to believe I would be that one guy. In the last 5 years, dear listener, think about all the various causes that you've given full-throated support to in the last 5 years. It's Trump. We were told Trump was the end of the world. I'm sure you know by now that was all bullshit.
None of us can even know something like that. It was upon pain of death, those people. You didn't go along with what Hitler was doing. You were in massive trouble. Well, you could get thrown into those places.
Yeah.
Now people just don't like you on Facebook. You have to deal with the annoying comments of people not agreeing with you or unfriending you. But come on, back then, you and your whole family could go to jail?
Yeah, but, like, think. People were saying Trump is literally Hitler, blah, 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 blah. Now we're sending billions of dollars to actual real live Nazis. I just posted a video on Twitter in Mariupol from the citizens of Mariupol where they were talking about how Azov was killing people trying to flee, which we've covered a billion times in Middle America. But that's not even my point. My point is to say, think in the last 5 years what the media has done. They convinced you that this guy was particularly and uniquely dangerous, that he was uniquely horrible because he put kids in cages, blah, 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 blah. And we all got behind it. And our emotions were all riled up. And you had people truly, I had people messaging me, Vin, you're black, aren't you afraid, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, I'm telling you, there's no fucking difference when you live under Trump or Obama or Bush. It's the same shit. And white people were telling me that it wasn't. I don't care about Trump or the rest of them. My point is, you really believe that you've got some like bionic mind that's impenetrable? You really think so? These people had you voting for a guy. They had you vote. They convinced you guys to vote for Joe Biden. Think. Tell me one policy that Joe Biden has initiated that has relieved the hellscape that Trump supposedly created for us. Look, it's not about Trump or Biden. The point is, the media explicitly has manipulated you for so many years, over and over again, and you go with it every single time. But you truly believe you're free? I would say, whoa, that's not true about, oh, you're a Trump, you're one of these,
Yep.
People get so triggered. I was watching TYT today about the shooter, and you know, go check it out in Middle America. I'll cover it. But they were trying to put the whole thing on Tucker Carlson, and it's the Republicans' fault, and blah 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 blah. Guys, it's not that simple. And if you don't wake up, it's over. Mm-hmm. And Danny keeps saying, question authority. What's fascinating to me is that. It was, when I was coming up, it was the leftists that were telling me to question authority. Mm-hmm. They were always saying that. Now, it's the Democrats, but whatever you want to call it, they're the authoritarians. Mm-hmm. They tell you what to say. They will fucking suspend you from Twitter. Yep. They suspended the New York Post for telling the truth about Hunter Biden's laptop. Like, this shit is insane. And people really, truly believed that when they were voting for Joe Biden, that they were saving America and the world from this dark force of evil. And so they got you. Mm-hmm. Sis, bro, they got you. The kids are still in cages. The economy is worse. COVID is still out there. I know it's not the major thing now. COVID is still out there. We're fucking flirting with nuclear war in Ukraine. All of that is not Joe Biden's fault. My point is, they manipulated you for years so that they could have power, and you went along with it. That's my problem. So now you have clear examples where Ukraine is using propaganda. It's clear. They're using video games, and it gets exposed, and people say, well, I mean, I'm not. What? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. I mean, I've had people come on the show and say, yeah, use those kids and women as human shields. Anything to destroy the Russians. What? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. I mean, this shit is crazy. So, like, I get it, man. Everybody wants to believe that they're the exception to the rule. Everybody wants to believe that. But it's like I said, the reason I'm very skeptical about the entire narrative about Ukraine and Russia and all the rest of it was because of what happened after 9/11. And I was completely brainwashed by the September 11th situation and the whole nine yards. Like, I don't have a problem saying that at all. Yeah. I'm saying this is a recovering brainwashing victim. Mm-hmm. But human beings are so egotistical that they really believe that they're the exception. They really believe it. It's unbelievable. It's mind-boggling. It's absolutely mind-boggling. Go ahead. What were you saying?
I'm just listening to you. I mean, holy shit.
Yeah. Yeah. So I agree with you, River. All countries use propaganda. The problem is that our country is supporting another country's propaganda efforts against me as a U.S. citizen. That's the fucking problem. our government should not be propping up Ukrainian propaganda aimed at American citizens so that we will support another $40 billion to them. That's fucking bullshit. Now, I'm not mad at Ukraine for doing that, by the way. I'm not mad at Ukraine for doing that, but our government is allowing it, and we as a citizenry are not holding them accountable to it. That's my problem.
Yeah, but what are the American people supposed to do?
Oh, there's a lot of ways you can make people pay prices, right? So, for example, one of the things that can be done is if the media was actually doing its job, it would be confronting them and saying, hey, what's going on with this, right? When we get confronted with it, we shouldn't make excuses for Ukraine. We should say, yeah, that's fucking wrong. And yeah. Now that we all have social media, we all need to say, hey, this is fucking bullshit propaganda. I don't give a fuck where it's from. Ukraine, Russia, America, I don't care. We need to call that shit out. What we shouldn't be doing is supporting our government fucking lying to us, extending a war that doesn't need to be extended, instigating more conflict. Our government shouldn't be doing that. Mm-hmm. And our government does not care. This shit is going to Exxon and Chevron. Exxon, Chevron, Raytheon. That's who's benefiting from this conflict. Mm-hmm. Regular Ukrainians are not. Regular Russians are not. And regular Americans aren't. So that's where I'm at with it. And no, it has not always been a thing. River, in World War II, the Japanese had propaganda. We did not propagandize our people with Japanese propaganda. We didn't do that. So it's not normal. It's not normal for a government to join another government to propagandize its own citizens. That's not normal. Okay. That's where I'm at with it. It's fucking bullshit. But everybody thinks that they're some independent thinker. And that they're not brainwashed. Okay. All right. I love the song. It's a 10. It's a 10.
I agree.
It's a 10.
I agree. It was super heavy. It like assaulted you. I loved it.
I really did. And he's really talking. He's talking that shit. And I appreciate it. I appreciate it. So, like I said in the song, fuck Azov Battalion. Fuck Right Sector. Fuck Putin. Fuck them all. Long live free people.
Yeah.
Wherever you may be. I love the song. Good song. And it was very necessary considering our good time. Then out.
Nick gives it 11. Sorry, out.
Gone. All right, guys. Here's River. We were enemies with Japan. River, anybody who tries to lie to me and then take money out of my pocket that could go to my food to my son is also my enemy. Right? If I came to your house and took all the capital in your house and put it in my pocket when you're trying to feed your family, I'm your enemy. So there's that. Because there is no way that Biden or any of these fools would ever dare to float out $33 billion or $40 billion to these motherfuckers if all of us knew the actual truth about what was going on over there. I promise you, ask any American, hey, do you want to give $40 billion so that these motherfuckers can set up howitzers and all types of shit by malls and schools and fucking kindergartens? Would you like to give another $40 billion to the motherfuckers who posted up in a motherfucking hospital? So that the Russians would have to decide whether or not to fucking bomb the hospital? I'm sure if the U.S. media would tell the fucking truth that there would be such a public outcry, there's no fucking way they'd be able to pass that $33 billion, River. I don't understand how you've got this lackadaisical attitude to the fact that our government is working with another government to propagandize me and you. How could you possibly be okay with that? I don't give a fuck what side you're on.
Yeah.
I don't care what side you're on. Hell, fuck that. Fuck those people, bro. Okay. Commercial break, we shall return!